Hi, I'm Tommy, developer of Battlefield Engineer. In this tutorial, I'll go through the basic gameplay controls as well as some known issues with the game. So this is a free demo made from the pre-alpha state base game. Pre-alpha here means that it's still under development, currently not released. And it is missing some major features and may have some severe bugs, but this is the first release of this game in to the public. So the first thing you want to do is probably set up your resolution. I would recommend using the windowed mode because the full screen mode doesn't like out tapping out of the game. It's a known issue that it might crash when you try to do that. And for the graphic settings, you need to save and then restart the game. For other ones like the general and audio settings, you don't need to restart. And from here you can find the key bindings and you can change the settings. Look at these tooltips for the meanings of these different combinations. You can also search. Okay, so this demo allows you to play randomly generated battles from that use ships from a set of about 40 ship designs made by me. So from here you get a new level every time, a new fleet, and the level might not be varied in some cases. This seems pretty good, but if you want to get a new one, just press escape. Exit the main menu, new generation, and so on. Okay, so this seems pretty good. And this now started in deployment phase, where you can move your ships freely within this. You need to place your fleet within this green box, which in this case covers almost all of the level. And here is the enemy fleet you will be facing. So to move your ships in this deployment phase, you select them by, you can do this marquee selection with left mouse drag or clicking on them. To add and remove from selection, you can press the use the modify keys, which are left, control shift, and alt. These three keys are used for several actions in the game and combined with the mouse buttons. And these modifiers are not rebindable. So to add selection, you hold the left control. To remove from selection, you hold the left alt and click. And you can also do like add removes with this marquee. You can also select from here and use the same modifiers to add and subtract from the selection, or click here too. You can also right click these to get these information window pop-ups, dialogues. So position your feet by holding the right mouse button and dragging, or if you want to modify the formation, you can hold left shift to scale it while dragging, or left control and shift can be also combined, and also left alt to create a new formation and then just gave it like this. These can be combined. Okay, so when you're ready, just let's actually move these a little bit away. End deployment from here, or you could have clicked the banner. And now the game starts in this paused state, where now you can similarly to the deployment mode, give orders to your ships to move. To give waypoints, you hold the left control while clicking or dragging with the right mouse button. To give an attack order, you right click on an enemy while this highlight is showing. Or to attack multiple enemies, you can, to clear an attack order, you need to give a move order. To attack multiple enemies, you hold left shift and then use this box selection with left mouse button, not right mouse button in this case. And then it shows which enemies will be attacked first, and then with this dashed outline all enemies that are in the list to be attacked. Which ones are attacked first is basically the distance and other parameters, driven by the distance mostly. Okay, now here we see that this ship is actually trying to move here to attack the enemy over here. This is because this particular ship has a very long range weapon and it's very small cheap ship, and it considers that this ship is dangerous at close range. It has close range weapons, so it will try to flank it, and this flanking behavior can be toggled with this option. So now it will attack straight, and if I enable this, and you need to unpause the game to update the logic, it will now try to go here. So this is sometimes important. Okay, then the game can be paused and unpaused with the default pinning spacebar or through this button here. You can also change the game speed with these buttons or with this slider between 0.05 and up to 10 times the normal speed. But anything above 3 is usually pretty heavy on your computer, so it might start lagging, and that's not very nice because it also affects the UI. So that's the basics of giving commands. If you want to fly a ship yourself, you can go to the ship control, select the one single ship, control ship, and then take the movement control, and then you can fly it with the WASD keys. These are rebindable as well. You can also change the lock the targeting, that you can, you only shoot at ships that you target, and take control of the weapon systems. So you need to enable this and then click on the groups that you want to fire manually. Then with that mouse button you can fire the weapon when it's ready to fire. You can also double click here to start forming a ship. And it seems we are losing this battle, but anyway. So those are the basic controls. And to return to the main menu, you can click here or press escape to get to this pause menu, from which you can also access the settings. And these two basically do the same thing currently. They re- return you to the main menu. So that is all. Please do submit your bug reports through this system. Write a description from where which I can decipher where the bug might be, how to reproduce it. Or you can, for discussions, you can also use the itch.io game page. And sending these reports might fail the first time due to your timeout, because the backend automatically goes to a sweep in the cloud service, and then just try sending again. I can't really affect that other than add a longer timeout, but that's not very nice on the UI then. Okay, that's all. Please enjoy the game and give me feedback on your any problems or things you would like to see in the game. Bye.